Hello and welcome to Belgrade, Serbia. Today I'll be flying with the nation's flag carrier, Air Serbia, to Zurich. Since this is an intra-Europe flight, I do not expect much from the business class seat, but I do hope to enjoy a delicious Serbian meal on board. Let's go and find out.
Belgrade, the capital of Serbia, has a population of 1.6 million. The city is nestled along the banks of the Sava River and the Danube. It holds a unique position at the crossroads of Central and Southern Europe. Owing to its strategic significance, the city was a battleground in 115 wars and was razed 44 times. The Belgrade Fortress is one of the most iconic landmarks in the city. It served as a pivotal military stronghold and witnessed numerous battles and sieges. It is a testament to the strength and determination of the people who have called the city home throughout the ages. Today, Belgrade is known for its dynamic and vibrant nightlife. Many weekend visitors from neighboring countries prefer Belgrade's nightlife to that of their own capitals due to its welcoming atmosphere, numerous clubs and bars, and affordable drinks. During a casual stroll along Knez Mihailova Street, I even stumbled upon a live concert at Republic Square. And let's not forget that Belgrade is the hometown of the world's greatest tennis player, Novak Djokovic. In 2009, he and his family established a tennis center, inspiring hundreds of young players in the nation. Belgrade has an extensive public transport system consisting of buses, trams, and urban train lines. The easiest way to get to the airport by public transport is by catching the A1 minivan. This express bus can take you from Slavia Square to the airport in 35 minutes at a cost of 400 Serbian dinars, payable directly to the driver in cash. There's limited space to store large suitcases. The 19-kilometer journey is generally quite smooth. Belgrade Nikola Tesla Airport, named after the famous American-Serbian inventor and a pioneer of modern electricity, is the busiest airport in Serbia. It is currently undergoing an expansion project. Terminal 1, located on the right, is used mainly by low-cost airlines, whereas the new and much larger Terminal 2 accommodates all other airlines. Most of the expansion work has already been completed. They are now working on the finishing touches. Air Serbia is the country's flag carrier and the airport's largest operator. It is partially owned by Etihad Airways and adopts Etihad Guest as its frequent flyer program. There are three counters dedicated to business class passengers and Etihad Silver members or higher. Afternoons appear to be a particularly busy time for Air Serbia. The economy class lane is extremely long, with a queue starting at the terminal's entry. If you are traveling in economy, you can purchase the priority check-in service for a fee. In this situation, I think it would be a worthwhile investment. Once you've obtained your boarding pass, you can take the escalators to the international departures floor. Again, there's a small queue. Once the expansion project is complete, the airport will be able to handle 15 million passengers per year, and hopefully the queuing issues will be resolved. After passing through immigration and the new centralized security screening, you'll be greeted by the new duty-free shop, selling everything from alcohol, clothes and souvenirs to juice and water. The central part of the terminal is called Tesla Square. There's limited seating space and several restaurants. It's clear that this terminal is operating beyond its capacity. The airport has two lounges that are situated near each other. The business club is a contract lounge used by most foreign airlines, certain credit card holders and lounge members. The other one is the Air Serbia Premium Lounge, located opposite gate A5. It seems that passengers from selected airlines can use this lounge too. However, during busy periods like now, they only admit Air Serbia's business class passengers. At quieter times, travelers on any airline can pay a fee to enter the lounge. The lounge is rather compact and basic, lacking any windows. It was pleasantly tranquil inside. The space is partitioned into two sections. To the left is a seating area with many comfortable chairs and couches, all equipped with power plugs nearby. The other side is a dining area featuring a modest buffet spread. The hot food includes soup, mashed potatoes, creamy chicken, rice and vegetables. And there's salad, various pastries and dessert. Interestingly, knives are not provided here, possibly for security reasons. For drinks, you can choose from a range of alcoholic beverages, water, juice, soft drinks and coffee. I noticed that Serbian cuisine tends to be quite salty, not only here but in the city as well. The mashed potatoes and chicken were on the salty side, but overall I did enjoy the food. The rice had good flavors. Lastly, the lounge has its own toilets, along with a shower room. Considering that most flights from here are less than 3 hours long, I think the lounge serves its purpose well. If I were traveling in economy, I would be happy to pay 25 euros for an hour here. The departure gates are configured in a large L-shaped structure named Pier A and Pier C. There are 10 aero-bridged gates at Pier A. Before the expansion, Pier C had 6 gates and now it has 14, significantly boosting the capacity of this terminal. The old building has a very low ceiling and appears quite dim. Luckily, my flight today departs from one of the new gates, giving me the opportunity to explore this area. The expanded space features floor-to-ceiling windows on both sides of the building, making it much brighter. In addition, travelators have been added to help passengers reach the gate more quickly. Air Serbia operates a fleet of 22 narrow-body aircraft, primarily serving nearby European and Middle Eastern destinations. It also has two A330s dedicated to flights to Chicago, New York, and surprisingly, a lesser-known city called Tianjin in China. The airline pays tribute to important and famous Serbs by naming several of its planes after them. The aircraft they'll be taking me to Zurich is an Airbus A319, which was in fact the first plane Air Serbia received when it was established in 2013. It bears the name Novak Djokovic. I felt extremely fortunate to be able to fly on this aircraft. Boarding commenced just 30 minutes before departure. If you aren't already aware, business class seats on most European Boeing 737 and A320 flights are the same as economy, except for the vacant middle seat and the separating curtain. This setup gives the airline the flexibility to adjust the number of seats sold as business class on each flight, but also makes them subpar compared to the rest of the world. On this flight, there's only one row of business class, comprising 4 seats. Shortly after I settled in, the cabin crew handed me a food menu and took my order a few minutes later. No pre-departure drink was offered. Business class passengers receive a complimentary main course and dessert for flights between 1.5 and 2.5 hours long. For flights exceeding 2.5 hours, there's an additional salad served as an appetizer. And for flights less than 1.5 hours long, only a small snack is provided.
Open the overhead stowage compartments or under the seat in front of you. All Air Serbia flights are non-smoking.
The flight was almost full, with only several economy seats vacant, but boarding was completed in 25 minutes, and we pushed back on time. Belgrade has two runways that are parallel to each other. This afternoon, we took off from runway 30 left. Oh, that's a bit of a shame. I have to say that despite being labelled as business class, row 1 has the worst seats on this plane. This is due to the bulkhead ahead, which forced me to store my bag in the overhead bin, and the severely restricted legroom. The tray table is stored inside the armrest, making my seat slightly narrower than the others. The seat is reclinable. I didn't see any USB charging ports or power plugs under my seat, so I suppose you'll need to carry a power bank if you wish to charge your phone on board. There's no Wi-Fi on this aircraft. In the seat pocket, you'll find two in-flight magazines and a menu, mainly intended for economy class passengers. There are sandwiches, snacks, soft drinks, hot drinks, and alcoholic beverages. The prices are pretty reasonable. Payment can be made in cash in either dinars or euros or by credit card. Elevate is a specialized in-flight magazine distributed monthly on all Air Serbia flights. It gives updates regarding tourist attractions, culture, sports, and recommendations for the next getaway spots. Furthermore, it provides information about Air Serbia's network, flight schedules, fleet, and official merchandise. The other magazine, Outstanding Serbia, presents Serbia's gastronomic and wine landscape, showcases destinations worth visiting, and takes readers from the best restaurants to nightclubs. Both magazines are worth reading, and I believe they provide ample material to help passengers pass the short flight time. The crew served us a meal shortly after the seatbelt sign was turned off. Seated in 1A, I was served first. My first impression: the use of plastic cups instead of glasses and paper napkins instead of cloth napkins made the service look less premium. Alongside the main meal, there was a dessert and some bread. The bun was still warm. I ordered the only non-vegetarian hot dish option. The portion was quite generous. There was a plentiful amount of beef mince. It wasn't overly salty, and the noodles weren't dry. I really enjoyed it. The dessert parfait is essentially cream with ground hazelnuts. It was pretty rich. Overall, the meal was acceptable. Although I don't think any of the three main course choices represent Serbian cuisine, the spaghetti was still enjoyable. After clearing my tray, the crew offered me a choice of tea or coffee. We are now flying over the Alps. As someone who lives in Australia, where our highest mountain, Mount Kosciuszko, is only 2,228 meters high, I was amazed to see snow covering a large portion of the Alps, even in summer.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have commenced our descent.
The actual flight time between Belgrade and Zurich today was just 1 hour and 29 minutes, which is about the same time as flying from Adelaide to Canberra. We began our descent just a few minutes after the service was finished. There's one lavatory for the business class passengers, located just behind the cockpit. It's quite ordinary and lacks additional amenities like body lotion or cologne. To summarize, it was a good flight by European standards. I knew what to expect, so I didn't have high expectations to begin with. The lounge, the food and the amenities were all basic but satisfactory. The seats are similar to the Jetstar seats in Australia, they don't have headrests and the seat back is rather hard. On the positive side, the scenery was beautiful, just like the flight crew. A one-way economy class ticket on this route is roughly 50 euros or 81 euros with checked luggage, while business class is 234 euros. These prices are slightly cheaper than its direct competitor, Swiss International Airlines. This flight is part of my multi-city itinerary from Belgrade to Bangkok via Zurich and Abu Dhabi, booked with Etihad Airways. If I were only flying in this one sector, given the similarity with economy, I don't think I'd spend the extra money to fly in business class.
We hope you had a comfortable flight. On behalf of the captain and the entire crew, thank you for flying with Air Serbia, and we are looking forward to welcoming you on our flights again. For your next flight, please visit airserbia.com and follow us on social media. Thank you and goodbye.
Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video interesting, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more flight and train reviews. In my next two videos, I'll be reviewing Etihad Airways business class product on the Boeing 787 and the newer A350-1000. See you again soon.